I'm going to use a solder iron. I think I'm going to burn a few things. Welcome back to the diorama I am making, and keen-eyed observers amongst you might have noticed there are some change. Yes, I've done some painting of the diorama floor, and I've glued in the bottom sections of the scout walkers. I also did some painting on the this thing over here, the runes. That of course going to be completely taken over. I've also done some testing. I'm not quite sure if I can see it. Some grass, but that's all for later. The reason why I glued in these two is because all the hinges were actually completely disintegrating. I'm not quite sure what happened. It could be that the paint is damaging the plastics of these Bandai kits. I have no idea. Maybe I'm using the wrong paints. I don't know. I'm just using acrylic paints and then some oil washes, and for some obscure reasons, everything starts to break apart. Not just these things, but all the hinges were breaking off. So I thought, let's glue it into the diorama using 5 minutes epoxy, and then use some super glue on all the hinges. So make sure that they're all now stuck in one position. So that's what I've done at the moment. What I want to do right now is to do some additional work on the surface. As I have already painted the surface, but there are some gaps now appearing between the feet and the floor. So what I have here is a white little cup, and short cup for snacks. And I got some sand from a local sandbox. Don't worry, they're not missing it. And I'm sifting a little bit of sand into this box. Not too much. That will be sufficient for now. I have here some PVA glue or wood glue, which I'm going to put in there. This glue is a bit stiff. Okay, not sure if this is enough, but I'm not getting the glue out. Then I'll use some water, a little bit of water, because as I said, the glue is a bit thick. Just a little bit of water, and I'm using a very old brush which I have over here, and I'm going to mix it all together. And what we are going to create is mud with some glue in there. And I'm going to make sure that I'm not going to lose much of the details. Now it may look a bit weird in color, but it's going to dry up. You have to add it to the diorama and then actually just wait for several hours until the glue is completely dry. As I said, I'm going to continue on doing at least these sections where the sand is going to go, or the dirt is going to go, and make sure that it actually looks like a dirt road. And of course we're going to paint it later on, but let's continue on making this sand. Wow, this is the guns, or the chin guns, for the AT-ST. I'm going to do some slight modification on these as well. Now I did paint them the aluminum, and the gun barrels I painted black, but that's just for now. A lot of German tanks had some sort of a cloth over the gun mount on the outside to prevent rain and so forth coming in. I think that's what that's for, but don't quote me on that. So I would like to replicate that. So we got here a piece of plastic. This is extremely thin plastic. This is from a very thin carrier bag plastic, and I made this shape, as you can see. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to glue this using super glue onto the chin gun for the AT-ST, but in a way that it will still be able to move up and down. Not so much that I'm going to actually move the gun up and down after it's finished, but I want to make sure that the shape will allow that to crinkle, that is the paper to crinkle. So what I did was I glued it first on the top using super glue, and I'm going to fold it around like so, but only gluing it on this section over here to make sure that no glue is going on the hinge. Now, okay, I don't really care if there's a bit overlap because I'm going to cut that off anyway. And then allow it to dry before I'm setting the next step. So allow this to dry right now, and as soon as that is dry, we're going to continue on working on this this plastic cover. All right, the glue is dry. Next step, I'm going to tilt the gun all the way down, the most lowest position the gun can have, and I'm going to glue the other side of this piece of plastic onto this over here, the section. Come on. Yes, okay. Okay, hold on. Okay, let me get a something to maneuver it by a little bit, because it is folded in over itself. Okay. Yes. So as you can see now, when I tilt the gun back in, it starts to crimple up. That is exactly what I want. And now I'm going to need to glue the sides, but I have to make sure that it only glues, if you can see it, only here and or here. And not any glue around here, otherwise we won't be able to tilt it up and down anymore. So a little bit of glue. Okay. Preferably the edge of the plastic. Okay. I'll let it to dry. I'll do the other one on the other side and I'll get back. Okay, I glued them in. I also glued on the bottom, but just folded them next to each, back to each other, and then glued them in and then removed all the excess parts. So we have this chin gun now, which has a movable, still movable. But it's not going to stay white, of course. We're going to paint this in a khaki brown, which is the color of those, I think it's canvas on the original tanks. So we're going to paint this, and then we're going to attach it to the chin section of the walkers. So let's paint this. And here they are. Probably needs a little bit touch up on the paint here and there, but it's in. As I said, we are most likely not going to be keeping this movable, but I can actually move it to the position I want and then glue it shut. Of course I need to paint the rest of the guns itself, but it's in. What I also did, I glued in the chin gun instead of pushing it inside with the rotating pin. Whenever I tried, it didn't fit, and these things kept breaking off because I had to push it hard and I couldn't get it in, and I'm not gonna move them anyway. So yeah, those are in. This one is in, and let me get the other one. This one is in as well. You can see there's some paint chipping over there, which I have to take care of, but that is done. So the next step will be continue on working with the weathering. Now I've already done a little bit of weathering with this one. As you can see, I've done some edges in silver. That is to suggest there is some scratches over there, and also done some chipping effects by using a piece of sponge and dipping that in the paint and then stippling all over. And when that's finished, we're going to do a coat of very diluted brown wash, and the effect that will take is visible on the ketting rod at the moment, where I've put on this this wash. It is a little bit shiny, but that's okay. That's how it's going to be. Another thing which I probably forgot to mention, and it is the decals. As you can see, I have added some decals. Added the cross and a number in this case. This one is 301 and this one is 325. There is some silvering visible, but hopefully they'll go away when I put on the wash. I've also put a cross over here. Not certain if that will be accurate, but once again, who cares? On the back, I added a small decal, which is probably the I think this is the filling point for a German airplane. And I also added this, which is a simple shield. Sometimes you have these tanks or other things with a shield or something onto it, or another picture. This one has a shield as well, but of course it's a different one on both sides. There was another shield here first, but I removed this, so we had some little paint damage over here, but nothing some weathering can't handle. One thing I'm going to do before further weathering, something I did with the legs and the bottom section of the ATSTs, I'm going to use a solder iron. I'm not going to fix anything, not going to connect anything, I'm going to burn a few things. Now, some people use a drill for this, I use a solder iron. What am I going to do with that? Well, consider that these things are in combat, or consider these things scout walkers and they're scouting, and whatever they're scouting, the people that they are scouting, they do not like being scouted, so they're gonna shoot it. And they're gonna shoot it with maybe some handguns. Oh look, we got some little holes where the handguns shot. Or maybe they shot with some bigger gun. Or maybe they shot with a very big gun right in front. So I'm using a tilting downwards angle, because whatever is shooting at it must be lower. So kaboom! Right up your nose. And yes, that of course has some shrapnel. So we're gonna damage the ATST with impact of small arms fire and larger. Maybe even some damage when it comes to the angle, the edges.
B&T, custom made models and dioramas. Ha! Like you click and subscribe you must.